Hi, my name is Wilman Ziada, and I'm a New York City-based director and creator of theater, television, and film, and I'm also a proud FENIX Global Artist Ambassador. Today, I am thrilled to be speaking with the famous Chinese actor, Hou Fuming, but he says I can call him simply Bill. For more on Hou Fuming or Bill, you can read more about him right below this video, but in the meantime, here is a sneak peek at the incredible talent of Hou Fuming.
我迟到了，手机没了。以后不管遇到什么样的问题，只要带上这个，对方就一定会原谅我的。我路过，看店里面生意不错，就进来看看。还好。我不想走，可以请我去你家喝杯咖啡吗？我家没有。
那你家有什么呀？淑淑，你死了，世阳就是我的，没有人会知道我是淑香。哇，人形虫啊！你怎么办啊？
This is Will in New York City. Joining us once again on translation is the amazing Chu Chen from Nepal. And here we are with the very famous actor, Hou Fuming, but he also goes by Bill, and he is joining us from Beijing, China. Good morning, good evening to you, good morning for me, Mr. Bill. And I love that we share basically the same name. Bill, I want to know, you've performed in so many movies and television shows. Is there one in particular that you enjoyed most?
Thank you, Will. 侯老师，今天很荣幸能采访到您，现在是纽约时间早晨，北京时间的晚上。 他知道您是中国一位杰出的青年演员，曾经在多部电影和电视剧中有过出演。那想就您过去的这些经历，他想知道您最喜欢的一部作品是什么，能够跟我们分享一下吗？
我最喜欢的一部作品是就去年有上映的这个《局中人》，《局中人》，然后是跟张一山老师、潘粤明老师一起有参演的。 他俩主演的，然后我有参演的这样，一部那个民国的谍战剧，这是我最喜欢的一部作品，也是我参与到的制作来说最大的一部作品，然后在当中饰演一个民国学生，那部戏给我一个很深的印象，就是因为我第一次去接触到，更有名或者是更就是更加咖位更大的这样的演员，跟他们去合作。 然后在他们身边去表演，通过跟他们的一些这个工作合作，能够学习到很多很多的这个一些表演上面的一些经验，对我也是收获颇丰。好，谢谢您。
So well, out of all the work that he had done, his favorite is this TV drama show. It's called The Insider Man, and it's about the life of spies. It was in the Republican period. It was a time after the Qing Dynasty was subverted and right before the new China was founded. And in it, he collaborated with many big shots in the area. There from them, he learned a lot of things, how to act, and he definitely polished that side of his expertise thanks to them.
That's amazing. And I want to know, as a kid growing up, Bill, when did you know that you had not only this talent and love of acting, but also you're a singer as well? And when did you know that you could sing?
Hi, Bill,老师，对，他第二个问题呢是。 在读到您的简历，过去很小的时候，就已经开始有一些唱歌的经历，所以后来不光是有演艺事业，然后歌手也在发展，能跟我们分享一下这个是什么时候发现有这个天赋的吗？
其实 讲实话，就是这个其实我自己本身的这个专业的方向可能还是演员，然后歌手呢就是会相对辅助发展一点，它并不是我的主要的一个发展方向。我个人觉得我自己在音乐上面的天赋可能不如我在那个表演上的天赋。
谢谢您。So well, according to Bill, he thinks that his talent in acting definitely surpassed that of singing. And so he would position himself more as an actor rather than a singer.
Absolutely. And, you know, I think that's wonderful. And I'm curious to know, Bill, you know, you've already done so many wonderful things within the movie and television industries. I'm wondering, do you have any dream roles or collaborations that you would love to pursue?
Thank you, Will. Bell 老师，接下来一个问题是对于您将来的一些电影和电视剧的一些畅想，有没有最想要去扮演的某个角色，或者是想要合作的制作方或者是演员之类的？
有的有的，我特别想去扮演的角色是杀手，就是坏人杀手类型的这样的角色。我觉得这样的角色，因为他可能脱离生活更多一点，所以我会觉得饰演起来会更有意思。而且尤其我小的时候看过很多，就我的父亲给我看过很多，我们一起看这个好莱坞的有一些这种动作片，所以我总觉得里面的那个反派很酷，然后很帅，所以男生嘛就想要自己酷酷的帅帅的这样的，所以很想去饰演那样的角色。然后想合作的这个现在国内的这种明星的话，其实有很多我个人比较想合作的，像比方说像现在的这个青年演员，有像张一山老师这样的，我都很想跟他有机会能够合作。然后年长一点的，比方说像雷佳音啊，比方说像这个邓超老师啊等等，就是都还挺想跟他们去合作的。
好，谢谢您。
So
well, that was a great question. Bill, he actually wanted to play the role of an assassin. Bad guys. That's what his dream was about. And he thinks that it's something that's detached from reality. And since he was young, his father would play the Hollywood movies, and he would find the antagonist in those stories. It's just really cool for him, you know, and how they talk and how they look and the things that they do. So he really see himself playing a bad guy one day. And of the celebrities in China right now, he would like to work with Mr. Zhang Yishan. Talking about a younger generation, perhaps he will. Zhang Yishan is definitely a great source of inspiration for him. And maybe an older generation, he would like to work with Lei Jiaying and Deng Chao. And so, yeah, that's his plan.
I love that. You know, I think I agree. I mean, my favorite roles in movies are the villains. So maybe one day I'll direct you in a movie and you can play the villain. How does that sound?
他说他也非常喜欢坏人的角色，将来如果有机会他自己能够拍一部电影的话，希望由您来演其中的坏人。
谢谢。 Thank you Mr. Will. Thank you.
I understand that, so that's a yes. Good. Okay, my next question is, growing up, Bill, I love that you were introduced to Hollywood movies here, you know, from the West. I want to know, do you have any favorite movies from the West?
您刚提到小时候看一些好莱坞电影，有没有其中最喜欢的一部？
我第一部在电影院看的电影是那个《拯救大兵瑞恩》，是我那时候才五岁六岁，然后我父母带我去看的。我当时就是被我印象很深，我被就很小那会儿，那也被这部电影去 就震撼到了。然后男生嘛，小男生就会喜欢一些那种在家在跟小朋友玩的时候喜欢那种枪战游戏，所以觉得就其实那个时候不理解战争的残酷，但是就喜欢拿着枪就是嘟嘟嘟嘟嘟嘟嘟那种感觉，男生就喜欢那种感觉，所以那部电影是给我留下了非常深刻的印象，我非常喜欢那部电影，然后以至于我后来我几乎是能够记住那部电影里面每一个角色的每一句台词。
哇、
啊、
wow.
对。
Xie Xie Ming. All right. So, well, his favorite is the one he saw when he was 5 years old, in the cinema. It's called the Saving Private Ryan. You're definitely very familiar with that. So as a young boy, you know, he likes shooting games and going to arcade and touching the gun was such a thrill for him. So this movie really embodies everything that a boy desires. And he actually canremember almost every lines, every sentence that each character in the movie says, according to Belle.
Wow, well, Saving Private Ryan, I mean, that is such a classic film, you know, not only for its action, but just beautiful storytelling. And, you know, while I'm talking with you, Bill, this makes me excited in why I am a part of FENIX, because here we are in two different parts of the world, conversing over our similarities and conversing over our love of art, and that truly great art transcends all language and all location. And I want to know why you're excited to be coming on board FENIX.
Bell 老师对他也觉得拯救大兵瑞恩那部电影真的是经典中的经典啊，除了动作戏以外，他的整个故事都是写得非常的紧凑。然后呢，他下一个问题呢是想知道加入菲尼成为我们的艺术大使之后有没有一些计划，或者说能跟我们分享一些自己的心路历程吗？
我刚刚有说到，就是关于这两年的时候我们会一直说这个人类命运共同体这样的一个词，然后我觉得说对于菲尼克斯来说呢，我觉得我们是对于就承载了这个词的某一部分意义吧，我觉得是这样。然后只不过我们是集中在演员、艺术家或者是音乐家在这些人的身上，但是我们同时在通过菲尼克斯去互相的更多的去交流、去了解，就好像我现在能够去跟威尔先生这样去对话一样，我觉得这是一件很就是我从来没有这样的经历，我觉得这是一件超酷的事情。对于我来说，我今天可能我其实我现在很紧张，我非常紧张，就是我觉得真的就是会让我是一个非常难忘的经历。对对对，然后这个然后因为现在的这个国际环境和这样的整个的这个疫情所导致的这样的一个这个状态，所以我觉得我们之间各个国家各个地区之间啊，通过菲尼克斯互相的再去学习再去交流，我们能够去创作更好的一些作品出来，同时服务于因为艺术家嘛，音乐家，我们去创作出来的作品就是要去感染观众，让观众能够去体会或者是能够去明白一些什么，让他们的生活能够找到乐趣，或者让他们的生活变得从精神上来说变得美好。我觉得这是我们交流之后，我们去互相学习之后，然后我们通过入驻这个平台展现出来的一个非常重要的意义。
We would like to bring our attention to this concept of the community with shared future for mankind. 人类命运共同体。So he think FENIX is the perfect platform to achieve that a shared destiny, that shared future. And it's something with humanity. And this platform does not just restrict itself to artists, actors, celebrities. It actually can affect the life of common people as well, like we talked about the grassroots people. Especially right now we have the COVID crisis. It's a time to collaborate between countries. He foresee himself as an ambassador that would continue to move and inspire the audience and to bring bring beauty to people's lives.
That's absolutely beautiful. Well, Bill, I am so grateful to have spoken with you today. And I am so excited, not only that you're joining FENIX, but that you are going to continue to spread the light and love that you do through your work that is going to just further the beautiful connection that we all have from all across the world. Thank you so much for speaking with me today.
And I would actually feel very fortunate to have met you on this platform. It's something really cool for him. I forgot to say. He said he's very anxious for this interview.
Thank you so much, Mr. Bill. Well, I can't wait to work with you. I think you're such a fantastic actor. And I want to remind everyone, for more on Bill, you can read more about him right below this video. And I am so grateful for both of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Bill.
Digital age, artists and bands struggle to make a living. In fact, only a small number of artists can live off their craft. For the 98% of artists that don't have the luxury of being signed to a label, it's tough. But artists deserve to live off their art. Wherever you are around the world, appreciation of music does not change. FENIX brings bands and their fans together, whilst allowing bands to properly monetize their passion. The FENIX app will directly connect bands and fans with no need for middlemen. We're utilizing the blockchain to give the power back to the artists once and for all. Join FENIX, join the change.